Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm John, this is Betty Intruder, and welcome back to Rome Total War Barbarian Invasion, where, as it ever was, some things are going well, some things not so flipping good. Up north, Spurius Flavius, the most Christian man who ever Christianed, is back in barbarian territory, and he wants revenge. He was humiliated by the barbarians last time he went this far north. This time, he is back with an even stronger flippin' army, and he is not taking any flippin' prisoners. Down south, the African campaign against the Berbers is going well as well. Appius the Honest moving in on one of the Berber cities. Meanwhile over here, yes, Captain Sebastianus is relieving Lepcus Magna. We should be able to save that place, but it's not all going that well, shall we say. We've got a bit of a mess on the Eastern Front. The Eastern Romans have got rebels inside one of their major cities at the same time as the Huns are flipping invading. Their cities are looking very, very unguarded. Athens unguarded, Thessalonica unguarded, their capital barely guarded and suffering from plague. So yeah, actually, if the Huns decided to swing south into Greece, there could be some very, very easy pickings for them. But if they want to go this way, yeah, they've got some big cities and big eastern armies to stand up to. Now, the Eastern Empire might be able to finish off the Huns once and for all. That is certainly possible, so we need to keep a very close eye on that. This might be the end of the Huns without them even ever actually attacking me. Which sounds good, but on their way to dying, they managed to trigger the Goths, who right now have Aquincum under siege. And that means the die has indeed been cast for poor Marcus the Gambler, who is now trapped inside and he needs to fight if he wants to survive. The Emperor is on his way, but the Emperor is going to be quite a few turns out yet. Oh yeah, like 4 or 5 turns before the Emperor actually is able to make it over to Aquincum, so that is no good at all. So let's start off with the Aquincum situation, and I realise I've made a small tactical error here, which is the guy who's guarding Aquincum, Marcus the Gambler, he's not a knight fighter. If I had a knight fighter here, I'd be able to sally out against, yeah, this army and make it a knight battle so this guy couldn't actually join in. But no, Marcus the Gambler is sadly not a knight fighter, so that is not going to be viable. But that's fine, I don't think it should be a major issue, to be honest, because these guys will still need to walk over to the battle from wherever they enter the battlefield. They'll still be some way off. Now, let's talk about the Gothic army, because hordes are not all created equal. Hordes are distinct to the faction that created them. So if we have a little look at this Gothic horde right here, you'll notice it's very, very heavy on the old infantry. Like the Hun hordes and the Vandal hordes have plenty of step archers, but Goths don't have those so much. They've got a lot more infantry, a lot less cavalry, and very few archers, full stop. Look at the other armies, same basic deal, step horsemen right here, but honestly, defensive 9 with an armor of 3, those guys are not very good, they won't be able to stand up to much conventional archer fire, and they're not long range either. These guys are not that tough, all things considered, but they do have a very large volume of step horde chosen warriors, so next to a normal horde, they're a bit more hardcore when it comes to their front line. Which is arguably a bit more difficult for me, because my normal tactic for dealing with a horde like this would be hide behind massive stone walls and rely on the fact their infantry's not very good to beat them during the wall fighting, neutralizing their cavalry advantage. The Goths don't really depend on their cavalry, they've got plenty of hardcore infantry to do the fighting, so we could be in a spot of trouble here, and that means I've got a very, very specific objective in mind. You see, it's going to take them a little while to build the siege equipment they need to actually assault the city. And I've got myself plenty of archers, and they've not got very many archers at all. The only archers they've got are the horse archers, who'll be fairly easy to take down. And that means we need to sally forth and do as much damage as we can to their heavy infantry. If we can severely damage the heavy infantry before they assault the city, I've got a chance of holding the walls. Here we go. Aquincum, only a minor city, so only basic stone walls. These defences are not going to do a huge amount of damage. If this were actually a large city with large stone walls, it would have a much better chance of holding during a city assault. But we've also got ourselves, a lot of basic spearmen, a lot of basic horsemen, not a lot here, but look at all of this. That is a lot of flipping chosen warriors. These guys, we need to be hitting with everything we've got, which is why I prioritise training all of these archers. The problem is, they've got so much heavy infantry, they probably can go one-on-one with my Comet 10 says, and they outnumber my Comet 10 says, they might just decide to rush forward. So I'm not actually going to pull literally everything out of the city. Instead, I am going to leave a small amount of my forces up on the walls for safety. And we've also got, yeah, some crossbowmen right here. These guys are fairly short range, but they're armor piercing. So if I can get them in range of the actual chosen warriors, they can do the job, damn it. All right, begin the battle. First, I get my infantry out of the front door. For the time being, keep them close by to the walls. If they get stupid and move forward, we should have the firepower with the actual height advantage to do some damage to them. They're starting to fall back, and yeah, the reinforcements are already coming in, but it's going to take them a little bit of time to make it over to us. Alright, while my troops just empty out of the city, let's have a little look at the line they're drawing up here. So, they've put all of their horse archers out on the flanks and formed a single massive line of all of their infantry. The more flimsy lads just in little groups over here, the hardcore lads part of their proper actual units. Meaning in the center of their line, they've basically got nothing that's ranged at all. All their range is way out here on the flanks. Now I might be able to use my cavalry to bait them forward nearby to towers or archers. That could potentially be of interest right there. I'm going to move you over to here and actually get my Sarmatians outside. See if I can do precisely that. One-on-one, my Sarmatians will absolutely flipping slaughter these guys. If they can get on top of them. And their units are moving forward, but are they just forming a new battle line or are they actually flipping charging? They're not sure. They're not sure whether they want to give me a poke, but they're thinking about it. All right, we've got movement. We've definitely got movement here. You guys hold still precisely where you are. The cav is going to see if we can just bait these guys forward straight into the range of the archers because, yeah, these guys have very little armor and I've got tons of armor on my Sarmatians. They're going to be able to stand up to a little bit of light archer fire. Shouldn't be a problem at all. All right, in we go. Let's just go and have a very, very light poke here. So they're going to, you know, get a little shot in, but these guys are not long range. They'll get maybe like one volley in before it's time for them to start fleeing. But if I'm very lucky, we might actually get one hit in and they start pulling back, understandably. But if we're very lucky, if we change target in a hurry, we can actually get these guys. Come on, come on, come on, come on. And right on top of you. And these guys are now engaged. We are now engaging with them directly. So these guys are, oh, look at that. Look at that flipping melting right there. Right flipping there. Now we just move over here and start going for these guys. Those guys are now coming after me. And yeah, the thing about the AI is it notices if you're actually attacking these units directly, it gets a bit confused if you're just moving vaguely close by to them. But the problem is we're being fired on right now and these guys are fleeing. You know what? I'm just going to change direction right now. They're too far away from me. These step warriors really want to come and have a go. So let's see if we can actually lead these guys over here back towards the wall. Let's see if that's actually a thing that works. And we've actually got some more cavalry over here. Hello, are you guys coming to have a little poke at me? Because if you are, how about you come over here close by to my archers? That'd be spot on. You guys all in position? Yes, I believe you actually are. In which case, you guys, feel free to take a few steps forward at this point. Just be ready to be involved. My Sarmatians are taking some losses, however, because they're being shot in the back right now. But I think we might get precisely what we want against those chosen warriors right there. They're walking straight into, come on, flipping do it, get into flipping range, and any moment now, any flipping moment now. Guys, come on, you must be, how are they not in range? How are they not in flipping range? Well, someone's in range. You guys are, stop, 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 everybody stop and start firing at anything that's in range, please. There we go. Now we've got some shots. Okay, I'm bringing out my general to assist with this. This is, yeah, they're starting to take some light knocks here, but these archers have now got shots down. How are you not firing, but they're firing at you? How is that a thing that's happening right now? Okay, you guys, just, yeah, don't flee. Don't flee, just stand, fight, all the rest of it, please. Everybody prepare to fire, and all this cavalry. Let's get that over there. Is anything else actually advancing right now? There's some light taps coming in from over there. You guys are ready to open fire. I'd like you guys to actually fall back. We're going to pick off this unit right here and go, 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 go. Hit them and then hit them with cavalry immediately from the other side and they break straight away. Because Horde units, even the most elite of Horde units, are not actually that flipping good. You guys, redrop your position. You guys, get back into position, please. We've now got ourselves, our heavy cavalry ready to flipping go. Good, 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 good. And I believe these guys are firing over on this cav, so they are losing their missile support. We haven't done much to their actual, infantry yet, but their missile support's going down. Once they've got no missile support, there's nothing to stop me just advancing and peppering their lines with my archers. I see we've got a bit of a problem here, which is those guys are actually in range of my crossbowmen, and these guys are not. So run forward, be ready to counterattack, please. Okay, what's going on here? Yeah, the reinforcements are here, and they're trying to actually join the same single unified battle line. So there's now more cavalry over at the far end. We should now have a shot at these bastards. And hello, what's that over there? You guys, fall back a little bit. I don't want you actually getting into too much trouble too quickly here. But we've got, yeah, these guys are definitely under fire. Now, move this way, move this way, move this way, and get him if you can. No, no, no. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. We might be able to get a hit in against these lads. And we've got one of them. I think they're going to be pulled into combat. That's another unit that's going to be flipping slaughtered. The Sarmatians are taking a lot of damage, but I would say it's worth it if we're just going to eliminate pretty much all the range capability of this army. Right, just finish them off. I don't want a single one of them getting away. And now, pull back, pull back, pull back. You're not going to be able to chase those guys down at this point. Now, we've got ourselves a few more problems over here. Guys, what are you doing? Why are you... Okay, I don't know why you're holding still, to be honest. Just fire at anything you've got a shot at, if you'd be so kind. Plenty of fire being laid down over there. Everything should be okay. This is working. This is working for the time being. 7% of us are dead. 8% of them are dead. Fine, we've lost a lot of cavalry, but this is still tactically worth doing because we're going to be able to do a lot of damage to these guys once their cavalry is defeated. And here we go, more shots from the walls over to these guys. They're going to start taking casualties pretty quickly right here. This is good. This is good stuff. I'm going to actually deploy these archers over here. You guys are actually doing pretty well so far. Let's just get you into a position to hit these guys. Stop, fire. 40 of these guys versus 157 of you, and you are pretty much as strong as them. So these guys are going to start taking some casualties. Oh yeah, that's good stuff right there. They're starting to... Oh, they're really starting to close in, actually. Hang on, they're closing in more than I thought they were going to. Right, all of you guys, fire at will. If anyone charges at you, feel free to do precisely that. You, what are you even doing here? I don't know what you're doing here, but you're here now. Right, what's actually coming at me right now? Not much here. Those guys are a bit on the tough side. Okay, that's more than I wanted to see charging at me, to be perfectly flipping honest. I'm feeling like potentially we want to actually fall back. Actually, I'm not sure about this. Right, bring the cav around here. We'll give battle at least a little bit. You guys, fall back, fall back, fall back, fall back. All right, you guys, fire at these guys. Cavalry, get around over here. If you can slam these guys in the side, you've at least got a flipping chance. Do not engage directly, mind. Oh, they're starting to fall apart pretty quickly. What even is that? Okay, if the combat 10 says are breaking immediately, I think it's time to fall back, actually. Right, everybody, back to the safety of the walls, please. Back to the safety of the walls. We're going back inside for the time being. This is not a fight we want to engage with directly, actually. So, yeah, everybody, start falling back. Start falling back, all right? Let the archers cover you. Just get back inside the safety of the walls. We don't have to engage in a pitch battle right now. That's not actually our job. So everybody just fall back. Let the archers get some free hits in over here. Everybody back inside, please. Everybody back inside. Let the gateways do their jobs. Let the archers do their jobs. And then once they decide to back off, we can just actually fire at their retreating backs. It'll be fine. This is not as bad as it looks. This is broadly what we were expecting to happen. And now, look up here. These archers are doing a good job. They're doing precisely what we want them to do. Here we go. Lovely, lovely archers firing into crowds of enemies, doing some good work. Everybody get inside the city and then close the doors behind you because there's quite a lot of barbarians here, actually. Are you guys getting any good shots in, by the way? Yeah, you're getting some good shots in right over here. So even though we are in a bit of a disorderly retreat right now, now we're getting some good shots in right at a giant pile of barbarians. This is not a bad thing, actually. This is good. This is actually good. I know it doesn't look like it, but it's good. Right, now guys, get back outside for a second here. I'm pulling my archers up onto the walls. Right now the archers are getting some really, really nice shots in. Alright, but I want the gates open, and I want something at the front gate just to keep baiting these guys forward. Because right now, they're in a really, really big crush of enemies, which makes them extremely vulnerable to archer fire. Alright, this is all good stuff, in fact. Here we go, a few of them are taking the bait here. Now we got some Comet 10 says, these guys are going to get some good throws in, but what they've done is baited a couple of these guys forward, and no, don't get yourselves flanked. Fall back right against the wall. I want you flipping fighting with your backs pressed to the wall, please. Go for these guys that you've immediately broken. Okay, well done. Well done for immediately breaking, despite being Comet 10 says, and thus your one job being don't immediately break. Everybody with a throwable up on the walls. There we go. Even the Limetane are doing some good work over here. That there is a general's unit. That there is Step Horde Chosen Warriors. And even Limetane up on the walls will do some spectacularly good damage to them, because the Pila are actually pretty darn strong. All right, everyone's fallen back to their lines for the time being. Let's just take stock here. What's actually left? Because I see a giant pile of infantry, but where's their cavalry? Where's all of their archer support? There's like one damaged unit over here. Is that... No, that's all infantry. I think we've pretty much eliminated all of their cav, aside from the generals. And I'll take that as a very, very good thing. Because my archers are running low on ammo right now. But that means at this point, what are they going to do? How are they planning to actually stop me if I just try and kite them with my archers? Here we go, speak of the devil, we've actually got ourselves a warlord coming in right now. And this warlord has decided to run straight at these Limetane. And if you guys can just hold for 1 second while the archers basically do huge amounts of beautiful work to this warlord, we might even be able, screw it, deploy my own general, deploy all cavalry. They're trying to send up support right now, but they have massively overexposed their general. I have got archer fire coming in, taking these guys out very, very fast indeed. I've got heavy cav ready to assist here. Yes, screw it. We can handle this. We can flip and handle this. I think we can take out one of their leaders right now. The Limetane have actually not broken. Well, flipping done, lads. Get over there. Take out these bastards. And these guys are broken. These guys are flipping broken. That's another unit of elite infantry that's not going anywhere. The warlord's down to 18 and is now being shot by archers. Oh dear, you thought the Limetane would be a very easy pickoff, didn't you? As it turns out, you're going to be momentarily dead. Oh, this could be a good pickoff, but sadly I think he's just going to get out of there. He is just out of there. But here's the thing. With no cavalry and no range, they can't stop my own cav just basically going wherever the hell it feels like. What have they got left at this point in terms of cav? There's this general's unit. Only 49 strength left on that, and that is light cav. Their general might be about to flipping naff off. He might be about to leave the field. Honestly, I'd rather he stayed, because if he stays, I might be able to actually pick him off immediately. Shame I don't have any light cav to actually continue the pursuit there. So, yep, feels like their general is flipping gone. And they're sending forward little units here. They see this Limetane and they desperately want to kill it. But unfortunately, that means that they're about to walk straight into a flipping kill zone. And in comes the archer fire. They're already shaken, meaning at this point, even though they're spearmen, we can just basically ride my general into the side of them. Marcus the Gambler has most definitely taken a bit of a gamble right now, but it's a gamble that's going to pay off. They're already flipping broken. At this point, their general's naffed off. Their morale is incredibly poor. I might want to try and bait the entire army back up to the gates again. Because at this point, I think they're actually going to give up very, very easily. They've lost all the morale benefits from their general. Oh, here we go. We got more chosen warriors coming in, and they really, really, really do not like the fact that I've got cavalry and they don't right now. They want to try and pick off the cav, but I can just lead them a merry dance all flipping day. In comes more fire on these guys. They're eager, but they're winded as well. They've lost their general. He's not dead, but he's naffed off, meaning they are now, yeah, they're winded, they're unhappy. They're going to start losing morale incredibly fast here. Limitane are tossing Peeler into them. They've just broken immediately. I think we might actually be able to win this battle, as ridiculous as that sounds based on the numbers on the field. But just because these guys, they're breaking before they get anywhere near to me. In fact, there is one tragic thing at this point, which is, I think I'm actually going to run out of arrows. We might have been able to win, but my archers are literally going to run out of arrows. I mean, look at these guys. They're wavering. Screw it. I'm going to go in. Broken. Next up, these guys are... well, they're eager, apparently. Okay, they're shaken. Wavering. There's two units breaking nearby. Oh, dear. The entire group is now broken. There are breaking units flipping everywhere. We are doing huge amounts of damage. These guys are shaken already. These guys are... come on, guys. Hold on. Hold the flip on here. They're broken, too. Okay, they finally managed to break the Limitane, but we've just done a huge amount of damage to their infantry, and that's what they need if they want any chance of taking this flipping city. Right, off in this direction, lead these bastards right next to... yeah, they're steady for the time being. We need to lead these guys round over here. There's more coming in, including the last cavalry they've actually got. But these guys are now going to be shot by all of the crossbowmen, and they've still got some flipping arrows yet. How are we doing at this point? 37% of my army dead, 50% of theirs dead. But bear in mind, their force was much larger than mine. There's actually... oh, why are we taking damage right now? Probably because, yeah, there's actually some step horsemen over there. Okay, these guys are just breaking the moment we get anywhere near to them. They might decide to retreat soon. They have taken a lot of flipping damage. That general is unfortunately falling back. Nothing we can do there. Move over here. These chosen warriors, we might be able to do something to them. Those horses are taking more and more damage. These guys are... they're shaken and exhausted. Get in there. Murder them. Come on, Marcus. You can flipping do it. The die has been rolled and it's come up. Double sixes for Marcus the Gambler. Right, just be a little bit careful, though. What they've got left is... yeah, they've still got some good chosen warriors. Pull them back, pull them back, pull them back. We need to get these guys in range of the crossbowmen up on the walls here. But at this point, they're determined and... no. They're not actually going to attack just yet, but they're getting worn down. They're tired, damn it. More and more units are fleeing the flipping field. They've not actually got much left, but neither have I. Screw it, it's time for another little push here. Get my infantry that is still standing back out in front of the city. I'm going to deploy the Sarmatians back inside, however. They are looking very badly wounded, and I'd like to be able to repair them up. So, let's just get them safely back on the plaza. I feel like they've done their flipping job already. Right, Limitane, back on the front line. Honestly, they're probably going to be able to do pretty well against whatever these guys have to throw at them at this point. Because these guys now have basically nothing that won't immediately break. Though, sadly, we might be just about at an end of what we can do. My archers are almost completely out of ammunition at this point. They're doing a great job, but that was these guys running dry. Now, it's nothing but the crossbowmen. And just look at the range on them, it's not great. It looks like they want to come for one last big push against my infantry. Honestly, I'm tempted to let them just because... actually, do I want to do this? I mean, I could start falling back at this point. If I just start falling back at this point, then... we'll probably still get the shots in. These guys are still firing. Yeah. Hold your position. Hold your position, please. Guys, stop where you are. All right. This is going to be absolutely fine. I'm going to use my cavalry. Just try and mess with their pathing a little bit. Some of these guys are going to start breaking immediately. If I can just cause a handful of breaks, that'll help the rest of these guys stand up. These guys are already wavering. They break immediately. Those guys are steady. Don't actually engage with them. But now we've got, yes, shaken. Shaken and exhausted. If I can just actually have these guys engage, come on. Come on. These guys are... they're charging. We do actually have some charging going on here. Let's just lead them off, please. Limitane. Okay, you guys can handle this, right? I think you guys can handle this. Right, Limitane are coming over. No, hit these guys actually in the flank. These guys are now engaged, but they will probably break as soon as they're hitting the flank, and that will be just marvelous. Yep, there we go. Come on, come on, come on. Broken. Right, you guys, do some good work over here. These guys are not doing a good job either. These guys are now just firing down with armor-piercing missiles. These guys are just being led in front of the towers. They're desperately trying to take out my general. They're not doing a flipping good job, though. And now, guys, I wouldn't actually pursue. Let's not go too flippin' nuts, alright? You're doing well, but you're not doing that well. Then again, maybe you flippin' are. This flank of the army's just been pulled off towards the general, meaning actually, we might have an opportunity here. We might actually have the chance to just chop through a handful of guys. I'm not sure they've got anything left. Another unit goes down to the Comet's 10 says on the front line. Meanwhile, my infantry are now countercharging and we're just chasing them off. They're all wavering. They've got nothing left. In comes Marcus the Gambler. Oh, this gambler's very much paid off. Into the rear. These guys break immediately. That is more free chosen warriors being picked off right flipping there. And now we can just start mopping up the infantry. Where's their general? I think the other general has now fled. He was a captain actually, but he's flipping gone. He doesn't want to be here anymore. Right, bring the Sarmatians back out here. We need to mop up as much as we can, as fast as we can. Oh, there he is. I've got eyes on the coward. And he's fleeing. I am very surprised, but we've won this one. And that's very important because that means I get to retrain between turns. My army will be fresh as a flipping daisy the next time the Goths move in. Oh, that is one hell of a pile of corpses right there. What a flipping battle. I wasn't expecting to win. I thought I'd be able to do pretty good damage to them. I wasn't thinking we'd be able to chase them off, especially after that initial charge where they pushed me back inside the city. I thought we'd only be able to do a little bit more damage at that point, but bloody hell, I am pretty proud of myself right there. Yeah, I think we pretty much got them.
The gods have favored you. The enemy are destroyed. Your victory is complete.
Oh, I love it when voice crack narrator man gets excited. Right. 4,000 kills on our side to about 800 on theirs. Oh, well done, Marcus, you big damn hero. So, some of the Goths have now been pushed back, but of course, they've got more. They've got plenty flipping more yet, so... Okay, I need to cancel some stuff I'm building right now. I need to free up some flipping money to retrain this army. Oh, this hurts to do because down in Spain, yeah, those guys are on low tax and daily games right now. That's no good at all. We really need to upgrade that city, but I need the money to survive over here first. So, one hell of a flipping battering, but we can merge some of these arch units together to save a bit of time on the old retraining. And with all that done, yeah, we can actually afford to get the entire army trained back up again. We could probably do with just a tiny bit more heavy infantry on the front line, though. We were lacking in that. So, one more unit of Comet 10 says, please. Also, how's religion doing right now? Because, yeah, there's a lot of pagans standing in this area. And, yeah, paganism is now slightly ahead. This area is just going to very slowly go a bit pagan. Purely because, yeah, there's a giant number of pagans floating around in it, just because all of the actual Horde leaders are pagan. So, we do have enough, yeah, neighbouring regions, characters and buildings to keep things stable for the time being. But just in case, I'll build a chapel, because if the Huns actually show up, that's even more pagan pressure. So, Aquincum is looking like we're in good shape. We might actually be able to destroy the Hordes right there. The Emperor's on the way, but honestly, if we don't need him to deal with the Goths, he'll be useful for potentially finishing off the Huns or starting to reclaim some cities off the Eastern Empire. I wouldn't mind getting Salona back. That'd be very, very good indeed. Up north, you have... Yes, Spurius Flavius has already actually moved into enemy territory. He can't do anything more today. Down over here, you've already moved, but I believe... Yes, here we go. We've got one more battle, a small thing, but a very important one. I've got to use my cavalry to take out the archers before these guys move in and cause too much trouble for me. So, I start off with the cav at the front here, but we can see the town in the distance. That's where the reinforcements are coming from. So, let's just be on the side over here so we can actually work around these guys because I need to bring my forces all together. Priority. Cavalry needs to take out the archers. Once the archers go down, we should be in much better shape. And do bear in mind, horses are faster than camels. The camels are going to take a little bit of time to get into position. And as for the Limitane, while they can't do a great job on their own, their throwing spears are pretty damn solid. So make sure we use them. You guys, yeah, stay away from the hillmen. They're spearmen and they have a throwing thing. So I don't want you getting in range of them. Work around them. If they start reloading, get the hell away from them. Looks like the hillmen are trying to actually track down my cav. That's fine. I've got two units of cavalry. They can't follow both of them at once. So if I just actually have one unit over here and one unit just basically squeezing past the hillmen over here, we should be able to actually hit these desert archers directly. They will momentarily decide to change target, hit these guys, and these guys do not like being hit by cav at all. They'll take some good damage nice and fast. Right, let's actually get my cav out of there because, yeah, there's Berber Axemen. I don't want to engage with them directly, so where's the camels? Bring the camels round the back. I want to get, yeah, one unit of cav one side, one the other. You guys are you charging me right now? Just going to make sure those archers aren't doing anything too bad to me. Get round over here. There's the hillmen. They are really trying to defend themselves. They're doing a good job right now trying to defend themselves. You guys do not have a shot yet. Keep these guys on the move. Keep the camels moving over here. Where are the... Are the Desert Archers actually chasing right now? I think the Desert Archers might actually be chasing right now, which is unusual behavior for archers. But okay, I won't say no. If you guys want to totally expose your archers, I'll just slam into them with cavalry from two angles at once. That all flipping works for me. So charge camels and charge everything else, and now they're all flipping murdered. Right, so these guys are now actually coming at me, but they're running straight into the peeler. So they'll take a fair bit of damage against the peeler right there. The archers are as good as dead for the time being. So now just wait for these guys to engage. Then we can just slam them in the rear. You guys can, yeah, hit these guys. You guys hit these guys. They're steady for now. They're not going to be steady for long. As soon as the cav come in, they will be in a lot of flipping trouble. Down to 170, wavering, trying to fight. Oh, falling apart very, very fast indeed. In come the camels! And even though these are spearmen, they should hopefully... Yep, they're breaking. They're flipping breaking. All right, everybody, just get on top of their leader. Concentrate all firepower. Job done. Ride them down. All right, nice and simple. There we go. Job done. Not too many casualties. Light handful of knocks to the Limitane. Nothing major. And with that, Lepkis Magna has been saved. And I'm actually going to send the cav back round to Carthage just in case any more Berber armies show up out of nowhere. Because while I'm down over here, there's nothing to stop an army marching up here and heading straight towards Carthage. Just about time to end the turn, but there is actually one other mystery that concerns me just a little bit. Which is, remember that Saxon army with loads of heavy cavalry and armoured Sarmatians and multiple generals? I don't actually know where it is right now. I don't know, it's not actually in their capital, and that's their only city, so where's that gone? Alright, time to see what happens next, and I'll be paying particular attention to the Huns. What is going on here? Oh! Okay, the Eastern Empire felt like fronting up to them, but the Huns have definitely still got some strength. Bear in mind, they're low in numbers, but what's left is severely battle-hardened. These are good units with plenty of flipping experience. Oh, and better news, the Goths appear to actually be heading down south, and the Eastern Roman Empire have moved to actually meet them. Okay, good. For once, it's not me in the flipping firing line. Oh, there we go. Huns attacking the Eastern Empire. Good, time for these guys to get a taste of being mixed up in it. And if they're very lucky, they might just actually lose Thessalonica, Athens, maybe even Constantinople itself, which would leave those cities very vulnerable to me. Yeah, I can deal with all of this. Right, well, there's no better place for the Emperor to be than heading in that direction. So let's just get him moving over there regardless. As for Spurius Flavius, yeah, let's just actually keep him floating around over here. This is not their capital, it's a large town. This is their capital over here. But this place is probably, yeah, more built up than this one is. Because this is, yeah, actually, that's a Christianized settlement and it'll stay that way. Because the AI doesn't really seem to ever destroy a religious building to build a different religious building. It just sort of deals with the religious unrest and tries to slowly convert people in the right direction. So that's fine. That place will stay Christian for the time being. No worries there. Spurius Flavius, you move right over here, because every moment you're standing inside this territory, you are converting more and more people to Christianity. So when we do hit that town next turn, we'll be in good shape. Though, where the hell are the Saxons? I'm gonna send this guy over here. Okay, no sign of them. I don't know where they are. They might be inside a Saxon fleet, but in which case, I don't know where. And here's a fun little thing here. We got a little army of rebels floating about in this part of the world, and reinforcements that need to head north, and... Oh, Oppius Flavius is right there as well. Spot on. I'm sorry we haven't really given you much to do, Oppius Flavius, but here, have some fun commanding an army. You can't even make it to those bastards. Well done, Oppius Flavius. Your one job is moving armies long distances, Oppius, for goodness sake. In fact, actually, that's something Oppius Flavius could be very, very good at. Because he gets so much movement bonus, he could basically just be a little ferry service that gets artillery up to the northern frontier faster. Ooh, that's worth thinking about, actually. He could be very useful for that. Oh, but here we go. Down south in the desert, it looks to me like, yeah, the Berbers have thrown everything they've got at me to stop me getting at their capital. Screw you, you stupid bastards. That doesn't look very tough to me. I see peasants in there and damaged units too. Oh yeah, they're falling back already. They know they're in trouble and they've got no range. Oh, this is gonna be great. And there we go. There's Dimity. We can see it right there. Hang on, it is... it's a city, but it is not actually the capital. Fine, the capital must be the one that's over here in modern-day Morocco, I believe. So, alright. We can take these guys out. We can knock down this city. It doesn't even have walls. It's not very well guarded at all. Shouldn't be a major issue. Right. Take these guys out and make sure none of them escape. We don't have much in the way of cavalry, but... use what I've got to chase them down. We need to make sure these guys are wiped out. All right, big sandy dunes and... excuse me, who are... sorry, I accidentally left one of my archers behind. Just a second. As I was saying, nice sandy dunes, and it looks like I've just got a high ground advantage here. So let's just, yeah, gently push up towards these guys right now. About there should be fine. And everybody run forward. I've got my mercenary crossbowmen at the front just because I don't want them shooting into the back of the combat tensors, and they do have shorter range. So yeah, we just need to get them in range of something. We'll be in good shape. I'm very happy to, yeah, have my archers at the rear, even though that further limits their range, because these guys don't have any range at all. Here we go. We've got close enough they're actually going to charge, meaning I'm going to immediately pull my crossbowmen back because... anyone stupid enough to charge is going straight into flipping Pilar. So they're going to try and fall back. These guys are going to not be happy about life. They're already wavering. See them off with the spearmen. That's absolutely fine. You guys do not chase. Stop, 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 stop. And yeah, anyone else stupid enough to come up to me. Hillmen are going to be hit by all of the Pilar. Shaking already. Broken already. You guys, do not pursue, do not pursue. Let the archers do the work, dammit. And here we go. The AI is now trying to desperately close up the holes in its line as we take out entire units with archer fire. But every time they do, they have to reposition, which means turning their flank or rear to me, which means it's even easier to murder the rest of them. Lovely. Here we go. Berber lancers have decided to charge directly into my spearmen. Not going to work out for them. Their leader thought about going up to the front line. Didn't work for him either. There we go. This is just about done already. I think we're ready to start moving our cavalry out to intercept the fleeing units. There we go. Nice and simple. Massive range superiority there. And a handful of camels get away. But I'm hoping that's going to be enough that this army just disintegrates and does not retreat to the city. Oh, that's a good number of corpses. Right, this is revenge for all that bother you gave me at Carthage, you bastards. Ooh, this guy's got himself a Berber turncoat, which is marvellous, and I don't see their army. I'm pretty sure that did actually completely disintegrate. Good. Time to actually get the flipping siege engines built around this place. We will be able to move in and take it out next turn. Oh, faction leader and factionaire. Oh dear, oh dear. Right, time to splash some cash around, because I'm not sure we actually need to be urgently building armies right now. Carthage is in trouble in terms of public order. I'm going to give them the first hermitage of the game. In Spain, you get yourselves, yeah, Proconsul's Palace. I need these guys to not be in trouble so much. I'm a bit worried about this place. And you know what? I'm actually going to get a handful of scorpions built in Rome. Scorpions are fun. This is artillery that's extremely powerful against troops. Very, very long range indeed. Can be very useful for giving yourself a big tech advantage against factions that might outnumber you, but do not actually have the ability to build artillery. And one more archer and a Aquincum just to be safe, but this army is now looking good. This is a battle-hardened army, dammit. Well, it's actually not, because it hasn't picked up a single bit of XP. Possibly the Sarmatians did. I think the Sarmatians might have done. But yeah, looking good there. Should be able to defend ourselves against the Goths, especially as the Emperor is getting closer now. Though, if I could let Aquincum take care of itself, the Emperor could head down to Salona. That would be one hell of a battle, though. That is... yeah, there are some comet tensors, large stone walls, and yeah, Legio Lanciarii. These are the troops that basically the Eastern Empire gets instead of the barbarian infantry. So yeah, we get some lovely hard defensive barbarians who are specialized in taking out cav. These guys are more of just an intermediary step between the Limitanei and the comet tensors. They just hit a bit harder, but not as hard as the comet tensors. They're well defended, but not well defended as the comet tensors. But they're not a bad intermediary step. Alright, this bit of the world is starting to get interesting here. Time to see what the Huns, the Goths, and the Eastern Romans are planning to do next. And what am I seeing here? Oh, I'm seeing Huns trying to move south towards Thessalonica, and that's very, very good news. The Eastern Romans are trying to block it up, but... oh! Uh-oh. Who just decided to betray us? Who was it? Oh, I think it was just a diplomat. That's absolutely fine. That's not a problem. All right, the big stuff here. Spurius Flavius moves against the Campus Chatti. Let's get some flipping rams in production there. I can't see much, but I do see some basic light barbarian cavalry. Won't be able to do much against me. Let's actually just send my spy over here as well. Okay, I see a small force moving to relieve this place, including Barbarian Noble Cavalry. Those guys are no joke. Defense of 24, attack of 12. They hit pretty flipping hard, but they're not going to get there in time. They're going to be late. While he's doing that, the Oppius Flavius ferry service is ready to go. In fact, you know what? These rebels will prove an excellent little testing ground for our new artillery. So, let's have a chat about these here Auxilia Palatina, because these guys are flipping great. They are rock-hard spearmen who will do a great job murdering any cavalry you throw them at, but they also get the ability Shield Wall. This basically replaces the phalanx in this game, because Creative Assembly looked at the phalanx and thought, oh, bloody hell, we created something that's ridiculously far too bloody powerful. Oops, are bad. So there's no phalanxes in this game. They're sort of replaced with the Shield Wall, which, like the phalanx, turns this unit into an excellent defensive unit, but unlike the phalanx, doesn't turn them into an unstoppable killing machine that can take out literally anything else in the game. Basically, while these guys are in this formation, you can actually spread them out pretty thin, and this line will hold against just about anything. It is an extremely tough defensive proposition, but they don't hit any harder. Naturally, they will do more damage, because in a game where the crucial factor is who's still standing versus who breaks, being able to stand longer via a good defense is itself a good offense, but it is not as stupidly powerful as a phalanx is. So we might well get some usage out of that. We'll have to flipping see. For the most part, we're probably fine with them being in a normal formation. And also for the time being, yeah, artillery, let's just start shredding the hell out of some rebels. Oh, bless them. They think they're safe because they're on the high ground. Oh, guys, it ain't gonna work out for you. I'm gonna be honest. Right, nothing too major there. The Oppius Flavius ferry service can just keep getting those artillery north. By the time we're ready to attack the Saxon capital, he'll be there. Though, if the Saxon army's not there, that's not really necessary. But still, it will be useful when we head over towards the Celts. Because, yeah, not having to face that main army, that will be useful. Oh, down south, however, the Berbers are panicking. I've got sight of a family member right there. I assume he was planning to attack Lepcus Magna and join that siege, but no. Now he's rushing back to Dimidi because he knows he's in trouble, but it's too late. Come on, Appius, let's go take out their faction leader and their factionaire in one beautiful battle. Okay, here we go. Just a nice little minor city, and yeah, this culture group, these cities tend to be very, very open indeed. Big, wide open streets, which very much works for me because I've got a whole bunch of archers I can actually stick in those streets That is, yeah, this is actually perfect. This is a lovely, easy city type to siege. Next, the Roman or Greek layouts, this should be lovely and simple. Though it does amuse me that, even though this is a different culture group with its own architecture, there is only one type of church building. So the church does kind of stand out versus the rest of the town. And my archers just move forward. Some of them have a shot, some of them do not, and... here we go. Light cav going down very... Oh, that's heavy cav, actually. No, that's one of their flipping chieftains right there. Oh, he's not going to be happy about life. There is going to be a lot of fire going in against him. Flipping love it. You don't often see this, actually, but yeah, both of the leaders have decided to be right next to the walls, meaning my archers have a really good chance to just thin out their ranks a little bit before the battle proper begins, and that is spot on. Oh, but you know what? Fair play to the Berbers. They've actually managed to find a position where they can fire at a ram that's already at the gate, which is actually quite tricky to do. So, well done for being in just the right position. But even if they burn this one down, I feel slightly sorry for these guys. They are not having a good time of it. Yep, they have successfully burnt that one down. So leave that one be. Simply move over here. We're still going to have two breaches. That will be absolutely fine. Looks like the generals are starting to fall back, but not yet, actually. They want a bit more of a go at the front, and they're down to 100 heavy cav. They had like 160 at the beginning of this. They've thrown away 60 of their best units already, so that works for me. That's very good news. All right, time to bring up the spearmen. It looks like, yeah, we might be able to get mixed up with the generals nice and easy here. We've also got some desert archers, but they're taking a lot of counterfire off my archers right now. Oh, I just love having archer superiority. It's flipping beautiful. Right, we got plenty of breaches and no sign of trouble just yet. I'm willing to commit one of my units of combat tensors right here just to see if I can bait any cavalry into archer range. Well, we definitely have some movement here. Yeah, we got movement from... That's the light cavalry and some light infantry too. So that's good. You guys just draw up here. Draw up nice and defensively if you'd be so kind. No trouble whatsoever. Just hold your ground. Let these guys toss in the peeler. Let the archers do the work. This should be absolutely fine. In fact, actually, it looks like... Are they going all in? Is that the flipping general coming in for a go? Because that'd be marvelous. Right, get the spearmen right over here. One unit over here, one unit right over here as well. Have you actually... No, you've not actually thrown all your peeler in yet. You're ready to get another throw in. And those javelins flipping hurt. They've broken already. Yeah, have you ready to move in if need be? No, no movement from the generals yet. They're staying on the plaza. But this is a very small area for a minor city. So I might be able to pepper them with enough fire to pull them off the plaza pretty easily just with my archers. All right, infantry is now positioned inside the town. Time to actually bring up the archers, nice and shielded from anyone else. Don't fire at will yet. I want you all in position before anyone opens fire. But yeah, in front of them, we got the two spearmen right here, more combat tensors over here, and two units of combat tensors guarding their flanks. We should be fine. And now we just slowly push forward until my archers have the shots. All right, they have a shot. I think someone's got a shot just at the peasant. So a little bit further forward. We're almost there. There we go. One of them has a shot at the desert chieftain. So at this point, everyone just fire at will. I think everyone's got a shot at the peasants. It's not going to be a great shot because these buildings are in the way, but it'll be enough to actually pull these guys over, hopefully. Here we go. We got the light cavalry and the peasants moving in at the bare minimum, so we can take care of them first. And probably this position's actually even flipping better because, yeah, now we're going to have a nice clean shot at these guys at the rear. So those guys are going to back off straight away. Peasants too, but yeah, now we can just lay down huge amounts of arrow fire right over there, and here we go. They are now coming in. Now, it's possible they will win this fight. It is entirely possible, so at this point, I'm actually going to pull my archers back for safety, and I'm going to send in reinforcements in the form of combat tensors purely to make sure these guys don't go down too fast, but for the moment... I think they're okay. These guys are shaken. The other guys are steady. it's not so bad. If they take some casualties, that's fine. That was literally their job, just to chunk through some enemy leaders and just very, very slowly finish them off. We do have reinforcements coming in. You guys are the ones who need the help more, to be honest. So, I don't know why. Maybe these guys are just slightly tougher. I didn't actually check all of the traits. I can't remember off the top of my head. Desert Chieftain is starting to go down. These guys might break, but honestly, even if they do, it's not a problem. And I'd like you guys to open fire anyway, if you could be so kind. Because if you shoot your own guys in the back, I kind of don't care. Let's just get a few more shots in right there. Lovely. Here we go. This Desert Chieftain down to 29 and then 28. 12 over here. These guys are wavering. This is going very, very well. So their king is almost broken. There we go. Now get around the back of the other guy. Ah, too late. Grab him if you can. Might be able to get down a few of them. No, bad luck there. Okay, guys, don't go too crazy, but if they want to immediately countercharge, works for me. So you guys, yeah, just bring you guys up, take this guy out, and start murdering some cav. This is pretty much done now. And I think we got the king. There he goes. Right. King has been taken care of. That just leaves 13 of the Desert Chieftain over there. I think these guys will be able to handle it. I'm just sending my spearmen in directly. I think actually the weaker unit, which is already shaken, will probably break. So I'll actually leave them back, just so they don't actually trigger the other ones. Yeah, you guys are slightly stronger. Right, let's just get you guys over here. Do as much damage as you can. I'll follow it up with the Comet's 10 says. In fact, what do they even have here? A meeting hall. I think that means I can retrain my... Oh, they've all already broken. Well done. Well flipping done. Right, deploy the Comet's 10 says. If they take a few light knocks, it happens. And there we go. I think they were all broken at the same time. Nice and simple, really. So, this place gets burnt down, of course, because we need to be moving straight on. And, yep, low tax rate. Repair it immediately. And what can I actually recruit here? Yeah, as I thought, Barbarian Cavalry will be fine, along with archers. So I can give the entire army a quick refresh. Very, very nice indeed. And as you can see, this place is already 100% Christian, so there is no religious unrest problem whatsoever. So this guy has just been promoted to faction heir, meaning probably faction leader is somewhere over here. But at this point, the Berbers are on their last flipping legs. And I think I'll spend some of that money on a dockyard for Rome, because that's an extra 400 gold every single turn. Very, very nice indeed. And as for the Goths, I don't think they actually fought the Eastern Romans. I don't believe they're actually at war right now. Hang on. The Goths are... No, they are not at war with the Eastern Romans. That's absolutely fine. I mean, while I'm at war with basically the entire world, that's just how this campaign goes. You can't really help that. It's just a thing that happens. And as for the Emperor, I'm just sending him forward. I don't know what the Goths are planning to do next, but if they swing north towards Carnuntum, there's not going to be much I can do to stop them, which could be very, very worrying indeed. Right, money all spent once again. The economy is holding together, but it's nowhere near as big as I'd like it to be. So many places that could do with further infrastructure investment are not getting it. Rebels are everywhere, and the pirate problem is just getting bigger and bigger. I can't even think about a fleet right now. I can't afford to build it, and I can't afford to maintain it, so we're just about holding on. We're doing well versus the actual hordes here, but there's plenty more to flippin' come. Okay, what are the Goths gonna do next? And as for the Huns, please keep going south. Just for once, cause someone else some flippin' trouble. And bloody hell, they're walking away from Thessalonica. Right, you better be going for Sirmium. Alright, you better flippin' be about to do that. Because if you're coming for Aquincum again, well, you can't. The Goths aren't done with it. Oh, and Mediolanum wants an Imperial Palace, because of course it does. Oh dear, we've entered another worrying bit of the game. So, at the start of this campaign, you get given a whole bunch of generals. Some of them are good, most of them aren't, but they're all generals. Mostly, they're useful to have. They're starting to die of natural causes. The older generation are passing on, and the younger generation are not ready to take their place yet. And as they die, we need to, oh bloody hell, yeah, we need to offset their absence by increasing the rate of games, lowering the tax rate. The economy is just going to start taking more and more hits, and in some places that's going to be felt more than others. Like say over here, yeah, this chappy, the pagan, who's doing a good job keeping an eye on Syracuse, He's 44 right now, but he's not going to be around forever. When he dies, there's going to be some severe problems in that part of the world. And as for the obvious Flavius delivery service, let's just actually pass by Vicus Frankie, because yeah, some of these guys could do with a bit of retraining. And I've sent my spy up towards the Saxon capital. All we've got there is the faction leader and just some damaged mercenaries. There's nothing here. Where's your army? I feel like I'm walking into a flipping trap here. As for the Emperor, time to move him to his favourite spot in the world. The spot where he won one of the greatest victories in our history against the Vandals, where their army's backs were broken. Lovely spot for him to chill out in. The Goths have not laid siege to Aquincum yet, but they still have plenty of strength. I wouldn't want to take him on in the open field where I can't fall behind walls. That would be very, very dangerous indeed, but Aquincum is ready. Marcus the Gambler is flipping ready too. And as for the Huns, oh, please attack Sirmium, not me, you bastards. Actually, I think they might have already done so, because over here, this faction leader is looking very much a little bit battered, actually. This is actually the Eastern Emperor right here. And as for this place, that is, that's not looking so battered, but it's looking wounded as well. I'm not 100% sure what's gone on here. Possibly these guys were pulled out onto the field as reinforcements? I'm not sure. Actually, they probably just took these wounds, retaking the city from the Eastern Rebels, who are not dead. They're still around somewhere. And down south, the army is ready to move on and finish off the Berbers once and for all, but there are leaders just heading over towards us over the desert. I don't know what they've got, and their banners don't look particularly full, but you do not want to go underestimating heavy cavalry. So we need to figure out how we're going to deal with those guys, or how much of a garrison needs to be left in Dimity while we make our march towards the capital to finish these bastards off once and for all. And if we can do that, well, that might just free up a beautiful army that could, say, join up with some reinforcements, some artillery trained in Rome itself, and then maybe we're ready to strike back against the Eastern Empire. Because, yeah, Greece and the Greek islands are looking very, very vulnerable to me. If we could just get a handful of troops over there, that could be some very nice, easy pickings while they're distracted by the Huns. That could be just the flipping thing. Meanwhile, up north, Spurius Flavius and his grand effort to pacify the northern barbarians will continue as well. We need to get inside this city. What is waiting for us in here? Let us have a little look-see here. Oh, it is plenty of heavy cavalry. Yeah, we have got the factionary and another family member, more berserkers too. We should be able to take it, but I said that about the Saxons and that went pretty badly wrong, so maybe we'll treat these guys with a bit of respect. Oh, and just in case I haven't mentioned, I can't actually finish off the Lombardi or the Burgundy either, because both of them are bloody Horde factions too. So isn't that just marvelously good news? Oh, and speaking of the Lombardi, something I hadn't really been thinking of, but definitely a threat, they've actually been expanding eastward. So they're actually taking over this territory over here, meaning they actually now border the Roxolani and the Sarmatians. If they were to actually take on and defeat the Sarmatians, that would actually trigger another Horde. Ditto the Roxolani. Oh, that's good. The Lombardi might accidentally trigger another Horde over in the east. That'd be just what I flippin' need right now. So plenty more to come next time, ladies and gentlemen, including trying to figure out how we can deal with the flipping Goths. How do we get them away from Aquincum? What can we do to defeat them? Because I don't think they can take Aquincum, but if they don't attack Aquincum and let me take them out in sally battles, I don't know if I can defeat them either. So right now, they are slightly awkwardly standing around. We need to figure out how the Emperor is going to be taking them out too. All of that coming up very, very soon indeed. But in the meantime, I've been John. This has been many a true nerd. And this has been Rome Total War with Barbarian Invasion. Thank you very much, and goodbye.
This guy's enjoying that. This guy's enjoying his elephant a bit too much.
In fair Verona, we set our scene. Oh my god, Becky, look at her butt. It is so big. They've managed to glitch inside one of the buildings. Elephant in the rear! And then in come the chariot!